Dr. Jeff Sherman here. Joining us with this week's Monday conversation is Marion University head men's and women's cross country and men's and women's track and field coach, Mike Holman. Mike, good to see you today.
Thank you. It's good to be here. Great place to be.
Now, you're just coming off of a competition down in Louisville, the Greater Louisville Classic, which was split up into three or four different brackets, so to speak. There was a gold, silver, bronze, blue, something.
Right.
Your women turned in a second place finish out of 33 teams, and it was the best finish since 2007 in a competition that size. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Well, it was an outstanding day by the ladies. Our top three, who were 6, 7, and 9 last year in our conference, also ironically finished 6, 7, and 9 in this competition. But they're probably the best trio in our conference in the Crossroads League, and they competed extremely well in tough conditions. You know, it was an absolute downpour, slippery, muddy, you know, wet, and they did a great job. And our fourth and fifth are beginning to develop with Anna Dudley and Liz Kester. So we're starting to come together a little bit with the Crossroads League meet coming up. You know, about a month away. So,
now talk to me a little bit about the top three that you have.
Outstanding young ladies. You know, you got Carly Warner, who's a sophomore, Ann Koontz, who's a sophomore, and then they're led by our tremendous leader in Lauren Borscheld, who's been an outstanding athlete for 4 years, and she's going to graduate this year. That'd be a huge loss, not only talent-wise, but certainly leadership-wise. But she's taking those two under her wing, and you know, her commitment and passion have just been tremendous, and it's rubbed off on the rest of the team. So they certainly set the tone for practice, you know, not only with the women, but I think with our men a little bit as well.
Now, the men turned in an 11th place finish out of a field of 38 programs. Talk a little bit about the men and what you're seeing from them early on this year.
Beginning to develop, and the young ones are starting to handle 8K a little bit, and the training it takes to run 8K versus the 5K in high school. Ben Hendricks is kind of beginning to emerge as our number one. Chris Hansen, who's been injured, is coming back now. He actually ran a race on Saturday and is starting to get back into the fold. So as time goes on, I think those guys will begin to come together a little bit and shorten that gap between 1 and 5 and be a little bit more competitive.
Now talk to me a little bit about it, being a dual sport coach. They're similar, but they're much different from each other. What would you say your recruiting philosophy is when it comes to both cross-country and track and field?
Well, I looked a little bit at our conference when I came in last year, and I tried to look at where we could make the most gains the quickest, you know, to start out with, to begin to move up. We had a good year last year with 10 school records and did some good things. But so I looked at the speed and power aspect of athletes that I could recruit that are 1, 2, and 400-meter runners, can also jump, can also run the relay. So they're going to begin to make a real impact very, very quickly in our league. And now we're starting to begin to fill in with some additional distance runners and build numbers. So bigger numbers last year than I think that was here before. We're about 20 greater than we were last year, and our goal is to increase by 40 going into next year and get our numbers up around 110 and 120, mainly because that kind of depth is going to be necessary in order to compete in the league. We may have multiple more champions this year, all league performers, but our depth's probably going to hurt us a little bit in terms of running for a championship. So that's got to be the next step in order to compete in that league and beyond.
Now, being that you're not only the head coach here, but you also work for USA Track and Field, being the scientific mind that you are, how would you take that experience that you had in Moscow this year at the World Championships and bring it to Marion University?
Well, very much simple mantra. It's athlete-focused, science-based, and performance-driven. So when I go to Moscow or to the Olympic Games and around some of the best coaches and athletes in the world, do the video for those, be able to bring some of that back to help our athletes continue to grow and get better. You know, you never stop learning until you're put 6 feet under. So continuing trying to get better, to learn, to adapt a little bit to the athletes here and who we're recruiting, but take those experience in the World Championships and Olympic Games and bring it back to our athletes here at Marion to help them grow. Those experiences, along with coaches education that I run for the last 16 years or so out at the Olympic Training Center for elite athletes and coaches, very much education focused. I'm constantly trying to get better. My wife kind of laughs at night when I'm reading articles and saying, you know, how much more can you learn? I said, you know, I haven't even scratched the surface. So it's always about trying to bring it back to them and then help them. All that knowledge doesn't do any good, as you know, unless I can impart that on the athletes, and it's going to help them get better. And so that's the ultimate goal, is to focus on them and their careers and trying to help them reach the highest level possible.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you.